you know, two mainstays in a lot of the East Coast and the Midwest, you know, Wi-Fi brackets, and beat Quid 3-2, the Pokemon trainer that sent Tweak into loser bracket earlier today. And Ned continuing to impress as one of my favorite players to watch. His clutch factor, you know, when his back's against the wall, is unlike anything I've ever seen in that set against Mr. E. Taking a quick dip here after a loss to Syrup in winner's bracket. And the winner of this, we'll move on to qualify here, Charles. So here we go, Battlefield for game one.
Absolutely, yeah. Ned has been really showing off the Sephiroth, and a lot of players will say that Sephiroth, you know, does perform a lot better in an offline environment, and I'm sure Ned obviously is a very skilled player offline as well, but just kind of showing that the Wi-Fi Sephiroth can make an argument as well. He's been definitely showing us the clutch factor combined with that one wing, a very, very powerful comeback mechanic, and when utilized with, you know, with a really skilled player, you can really see the potency of it.
Yeah, I feel like both these characters, the comeback mechanic is 110% going to be an X factor once we get to the late stages of this game. Obviously, Sephiroth with, you know, the one wing mechanic, but Lucario, you know, with the added ability of Aura and Rage, you know, combined on top of that, you know, you could potentially be seeing some really early stocks taken by Armadillo, especially because Sephiroth is on the lighter side of things.
Yeah, and, you know, there's been a lot of DLC with a bunch of different comeback mechanics, but realistically, Lucario was the first character with a comeback mechanic in Smash history, was the prototype of Rage, was the only character that kind of got powered up the more damage he was in Brawl, and then that kind of transferred universally to Smash 4. So very interesting just past of the mechanics. But yeah, just kind of, we see the one wing out and the aura not getting too much damage off the aura. He's only currently at 57%. This is like, oh wow, he's able to land the back. That was pretty much one of the few moves that Armadillo could actually get the KO with because he had so little damage on top of him. So that's why, like, Lucario can be weak at some times because he does not have enough damage on him. But still was able to get the kill. Very nice.
Yeah, great call out on the jump from the platform right there. And, you know, let's see what Ned's answer is going to be here. You know, he played a lot of these sets today, you know, inside out, having to make these big comebacks. And obviously, you know, because of how Sephiroth functions as a character, makes it much easier to do so, but Armadillo is doing a really good job just being evasive. You see a lot of Lucario mains really, you know, get their bread and butter movement down with these B reverse aerials, you know, with the Aura Sphere. So, you know, Armadillo doing, you know, what Lucario does best in that scenario.
Oh, absolutely. And you see Lucario being floaty as well. So, gonna with the great air drift, with the floatiness, Lucario is going to be able to use all those tricks in of the trade to get the landing, you know, hitbox he needs. But Ned, beautiful up air. That up air from Sephiroth covers so much area. Does have a little bit of startup and some end lag, but it's just so worth it in terms of how much area you are covering and the kill potency on that move.
Yeah, you know, as much as Armadillo, I'm sure has the wear it all to, you know, be reverse in and out of disadvantage and just kind of mix up his landing. There's no hiding from Sephiroth's up there. The hitbox on that move is absolutely insane.
Right, right. And that's going to be such a great tool because you see the air movement, again, I want to point out, that Lucario does have in the air just, you know, just by himself. And then on top of that, with all the B reverses, you're going to have, like, just having very wide hitboxes is going to be great. In Smash 4, you know, Cloud did really well against Lucario, and Sephiroth kind of, you know, bringing a bigger sword to this fight is also going to have a lot of space to control. But wow, time and time again, Armadillo is able to find these, like, really hard-hitting moves and, like, not even really abusing, like, super max Rage or max Aura, just really solid play, honestly, getting the back air, getting this forward smash set up, just very, very solid opening here from Armadillo.
Yeah, it's definitely an awkward game of cat and mouse if you're Ned. You know, as great as the range of Masamune is, you know, you see him trying to generate a lot of his offense with neutral air up close, and getting that close into Lucario's wheelhouse like that is very, very scary. So definitely something you want to maybe pay attention to later on in the set.
And this is worst case scenario here. Ned does get the one wing, but he has to use the jump early. The up B will cover him for the most part, but Lucario, he has so much kill potency with this amount of aura already at 100%. This Sephiroth could just melt in no time. The dash attack does not get the punish, almost getting the neutral B into side B setup. This is so close, and Armadillo is still up an entire stock.
Ooh, gets him with the down smash, but not enough to kill just yet. Ned still searching for this kill. And he's made really good use of that short hop up air, like you said. You know, the startup on it's, you know, very notable, but the range that it covers low to the ground is excellent. And that back air covering so much range. So we've seen Ned make a couple of these comebacks today, Charles. I wouldn't be surprised to see him make this one close near the end.
Yeah, we'll see how long this one wing lasts. I'm guessing, I'm not too, like, 100% sure on the damage, but he probably has it up until he gets Lucario up to, like, 60 or 70-ish. We'll see how much Ned can, like, get in terms of value. With the one wing, you know, your moves are more powerful, so you're going to be able to get the stock a lot early. You're going to have more combos available to you as well because of the speed, but all of that doesn't matter if Armadillo is able to land the Lucario back air. This move does have a little bit of startup and does... You know, you want to get that hard hit spot, and it can be really difficult to do in a lot of matchups, but Armadillo is making it look so easy here against Sephiroth, and it could be because of how tall Sephiroth is, right? Like, just being such a large target, you don't really have to sink that back air low. Like, any height back air, as long as you get the horizontal spacing down, like, you're going to get the hit.
Yeah, no, that's a huge factor right there. You know, you see that sort of archetype with a couple characters in this game. They're these taller, you know, lighter weight characters like Sephiroth, and Rosalina is another one that comes to mind as well. And, you know, Lucario is so shifty with how he, you know, shifts around his own hurtbox and stuff that, you know, I'm sure Ned had a read is like, okay, he might land here. I'm going to go for the side B. And as great as a move as, you know, the Shadow Flare is, it leaves you wide open for a counter attack if your opponent's, you know, that close into you. So Armadillo going to take that one to the bank and run with it. And again, stakes are big right now, Charles. Winner of this qualifies for the offline portion of the Smash World Tour. There's only a couple of these spots left, so.
And it looks like we are going to have the Pokemon battle. Ned switching off the Sephiroth. Sephiroth has done him much good throughout this Smash World Tour bracket, but I think it's time to rewind the clock and take us back to the Ned Pokemon.
Yeah, Lord forgive me. I'm about to go back to the old me. As Ned is going to, you know, bring us back through time with the Pokemon trainer, like you said, you know, I feel like it's been so long since you've seen an offline tournament, you forget that Ned is a prominent Pokemon trainer main, but you know, this do not sleep on this counter pick.
Yeah, and definitely known for the Squirtle, especially when the game first launched. Ned was very, very heavy Squirtle player, definitely known as one of the best Squirtle players as well. Has definitely improved since then and really improved the roster of his whole, you know, squad, the Ivysaur, the Charizard. You got to level up the Pokemon even, you know? You can't just put it all into one Pokemon. That can kind of work sometimes, but not all the time.
Yeah, and it's going to be an interesting war of attrition here. You know, obviously you've seen it with a lot of Pokemon trainers in these Wi-Fi tournaments. You know, you stick with Squirtle for the bread and butters, and then it's really Ivysaur and Charizard that make up the bulk of your bullpen to try to get you through the rest of the game. And, you know, like we mentioned before, being a bigger character against Lucario can be very dangerous. However, Charizard hits like a truck, so if there's ever Really?
Wow, yeah, that killed.
Wow.
Maybe some sus DI, or maybe that move is just strong. That Lucario up B, you know, it does get increased distance as you get more percentage on you. It does, the range increases with the aura. But because of that, maybe Armadillo should have sunk a little lower. I feel like with that angle, that arc, he kind of overshot the ledge just a tad bit, making it a little easier for Ned to get that down tilt and get that KO.
Yeah, whoever said you can't win a fight with a headbutt was lying. Charizard definitely just did, so.
Okay, Ned holding on strong here with the Squirtle, not opting to get out. There it is, gets his damage. And like you said, now it's time for the KO with the Ivysaur. Edgeguard going to reset to ledge here. Is he going to get the down air? No, goes for the forward smash, doesn't connect, almost gets a pivot grab as well. Ned onto the ledge here, and that Aura Sphere is going to be so hard to deal with when you are on the ledge or in the corner against Lucario, especially with Aura, because it makes the, you know, the Aura Sphere even bigger.
Yeah, when you start hearing when you have to start turning the volume down on your TV because the Aura Sphere is getting too loud, you know you're probably in some sort of danger. And, you know, Ned has gotten a lot of extra credit out of the stock, and there we go. You know, the fear of what could have came after the Aura Sphere led him perfectly into the Force Palm. So, you know, good stuff from Armadillo there. And, you know, for all things considered, you know, as cliche as it sounds, this is still essentially an even match.
Yeah, and that's the scary thing about Lucario. Like, a lot of his moves that are going to get the KO are a little slower. So, you know, sometimes you are going to have to guess or get, you know, those hard reads with Lucario. But, you know, your moves hit hard. You have a very, you know, large projectile when the aura's up. And that Force Palm is, well, going to be a slower command grab. But, damn, that move is very strong to get the KO extremely early. So there's always a lot to respect when dealing with Lucario.
Ooh, there was a re-grab situation right there. But, you know, Ned not in a position to get a punish out of it, so Armadillo able to reset things in neutral. Ooh, but getting a little too comfortable with the Aura Sphere B reverses as Ned's there to greet him with a Charizard back air as where Ned finds himself up one stock here.
Yeah, now it's time for Squirtle to get that damage. The forward smash is enough.
Wow.
Got KO'd while switching? I don't think I've ever seen that. I've watched this game for years. I don't think I've ever seen that. So
yeah, that's a new one for me too.
Maybe try to use switch to, like, I know there's some moves that increase your momentum in Hitstun, and then there's some moves that stop your momentum in Hitstun. So maybe try to use the switch to stop the momentum, didn't work out. Nonetheless, I was going to be surprised if he were to survive that anyway, as Squirtle so light. The down air, can you get the repeat, goes up and over, the nair does not connect. Very good recovery by Armadillo.
Yeah, excellent stuff right there. Giving himself a, you know, a puncher's chance here. You know, 30% separating the two, and as we mentioned, is definitely nothing to scoff at here. You see Ned, you know, searching for the home run hit here, does get the back air. So we set up another scenario here on the ledge.
Ooh, there's the forward air. It is not enough. Lucario, can he get back onto the stage with all of this rage, with all of this aura? Okay, there's the nair. Platform tech chase gets the roll read in, and Ned finishes it off with the Charizard up smash.
Yeah, that was just a great conversion right there from Ned. You saw him back off the ledge just a little bit, you know, reset his timing, not going to overcommit to an option at the ledge right there. And, you know, the nair set up a tech scenario on the platform, you know, so then because Charizard's up smash is so big, I feel like that he really didn't have to move that much to cover, you know, whichever way Armadillo was going to roll. So the counter pick working out in spades right there, both stage wise and character wise for Ned right there. So we are back at even games here.
Yeah, I feel like with PT, Ned, maybe, you know, Sephiroth is a new character as well, right? So maybe you're not really super comfortable with Sephiroth in every single matchup, right? Lucario, definitely not a very popular character, especially in terms of these later parts of the bracket, especially in, you know, with the offline tournaments. So maybe don't have too much experience. In those kind of situations, just kind of go with the character that you have the most game time with. You know, you're just more comfortable. And yeah, definitely felt like we saw that in Ned's gameplay. We saw Ned, you know, spacing out with the Charizard backers. He just had so many options that could just secure the KO and not really let this Lucario aura get too out of control.
Yep. Yeah, no, 100%. You know, like you said, when you get to this point in the bracket, especially with as much at stake there as there is, you know, just sometimes the best option is just to go for your comfort pick. So FD is going to be the choice here for the stage. What do you think of the stage choice here for Armadillo?
It's going to be nice and open here. Or you're going to control a lot of space. You know, Ned's not going to have those platforms for the platform tech chase. Platform tech chasing, obviously, very good with characters like Ivysaur, Charizard. They have ridiculously huge upward hitboxes that cover large amounts of areas. So platforms will always be nice for them. And, you know, just kind of keeping the stage nice and open so Aura Sphere will have more threat, especially in a scenario where, you know, Ned doesn't have a double jump and he has to, like, maybe, you know, essentially challenge Aura Sphere on the way down. It's going to be very, very good. And Lucario just very, you know, benefits a lot from Aura Sphere ledge trapping, especially just on the ledge or, you know, forcing your opponent to that corner.
Yeah, just like that, you see the game essentially even right here. And, you know, like you said, we could see a scenario, you know, late game where Armadillo might have to force Ned to land in the middle of the stage. So definitely be mindful of that. But, you know, right now it's, you know, a pretty comfortable Ivysaur percents right now. Ned going for a home run read right there. And thankfully for him, not getting punished super hard on it.
Yeah, Ned is not afraid to go for the read with these up smashes. Is able to get the side B there, connecting right into the up air. That will be the confirm. And yeah, like I said, just having that Ivysaur, having that Charizard, such comfort picks to, like, set up these kill confirms or set up these stray hits. And then just Squirtle comes right in, gets all the damage he needs. And just the main thing against Lucario, I just have to emphasize, is closing out that stock. Just because, you know, ooh, oh my goodness, well, we're melting stocks out here. And that had to have been, like, some kind of cross-up DI. Wow, especially on the nair. So is able to survive there. Charizard coming in, doesn't get the tech, and yeah, okay. But two stocks in one, this is rough.
Yeah, no, this is definitely a bigger comeback than I'm sure Armadillo would like to be making right now. But, you know, like I said, you don't want to get too comfortable against Lucario. Like, this is a character where if you're fighting against him, you don't feel comfortable until, like, the game screen says you can. And again, this early percent Squirtle looking really, really clean right now for Ned.
Yep, just tacking on the damage. He's not quite done yet. You know, most Squirtles will tag out at around that 50% mark, but Ned going for a little bit more. Squirtle's neutral, definitely the strongest of the three. You know, very hard to hit character, very quick hitboxes. Trying to go for the edge, but Ned coming in with a very aggressive nair, does get the hit. Very good, and kind of bails him out and gets him back into the neutral situation. I really like that neutral air.
Yeah, great use of the switch right there, and the neutral, like you said. Getting himself back in a favorable position, but committing to the Flame Breath. Armadillo going for the high on stage recovery, and the back air will clean up that stock. So, you know, despite losing a stock early, you know, being down 2 stocks to 1, Armadillo is right back in the thick of things, Charles.
Yeah, and it's that Lucario floatiness that was able to, you know, use the double jump, get the down air, though. Wow, what a read coming out from Ned. Gonna complete the edge guard. That was looking like a very scary game 3, though. Like you said, a stock earlier. You can't really, you know, it's not really over for Lucario unless it says game, just because of how volatile that aura can be, especially if it's a last stock scenario.
Yeah, man, it's absolutely terrifying. And, you know, again, the counter pick, you know, definitely worked out in spades for Ned's right there, too. So, if you're Armadillo, you know, I know he had a couple of, I don't exactly recall who he had as a secondaries on the screen right there, but, you know, maybe you go for the switch. I'm not sure. You know, you're one game away from having to, you know, try your luck in the last chance qualifier. And judging by the level of competition there, I would want to stay as far away from that as humanly possible. So, you know, curious to see what the counter pick is going to be here.
Yeah, Armadillo is going to have the option to go Pyra. He did opt to go Pyra a little bit in his loser's run. And, you know, shout out to Armadillo because I believe, let me check here, he played three back-to-back game 5 sets before going into this set. So, I mean, just playing his heart out today. And we'll see if this set also goes to a game 5. Right now coming up game 4. We'll see if the big question is Armadillo going to switch to the Pyra? I think, yes, just stick with the Lucario at this point. We'll see if the stage changes here or if we're just going to see Final Destination once again.
Yeah, we shall see here, folks. Ned, one game away from advancing on into the Smash World Tour East Coast Finals. Armadillo, one game away from sending it to a game 5, so we're going to go to town and city here. Change of scenery. I guess I'm curious for what Armadillo's looking for in the stage. I guess having some platforms to escape to maybe get out of disadvantage a little bit easier. You know, might be what the wave is here, but, you know, we'll see if it works out for him.
Yeah, maybe he just feels like he's dying a little bit more off the top as well from Ned. You know, Town does have that higher ceiling, but the smaller side blast zones, and we definitely see Armadillo really lean towards, you know, forward smash or back air for these KOs. So maybe trying to get some even earlier KOs with this Town and City pick and still kind of have that Final Destination feel as the platforms come in and out.
Ooh, there you go. I always get so nervous whenever, you know, Squirtle has, you know, those, like, low percent, like, tech chase scenarios, man. Like, even on Wi-Fi, you know, as Squirtle definitely falls out of favor, you know, past a certain percent, it's still nothing to scoff at.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, and this might be the KO. Wow, barely surviving. Perfect DI from Ned there. You saw him go straight to the absolute corner, utilized every single bit of blast zone he could, and is straight switched to the Zard, even though at 91%. Ivysaur not even going to see play here for this first stock.
Yeah, definitely want to get as much durability as his last stock as you can, as the percents are essentially even right now. Oh my god!
Oh, the back air. Like, and you know, both of them are just, they really want that back air, right? Especially when it's Zard Lucario, it's like, alright, how am I going to hit my back air but not get hit by yours?
Gotta call it like it is, Charles. Sometimes the back air is just nice.
Yep, exactly. See if Ivysaur, we have prime rage percentages here, and Ivy can do some nasty things. We'll see if we get a landing landing back air or a Nair starter here. Ned, still trying to search for this. Utilizing the platforms, I like that. That's a very common piece of strat. And the deep back air, going to catch the dash back.
Yeah, no, excellent stuff right there from Armadillo. Again, you always want to try to close the gap as early as you can. You know, Ned obviously knows the stakes of this match right now. And going right back to Squirtle, you know, you're trying to get as much damage in the early percent as he can right now.
Ooh, I like the down smash as well. Down smash for, wow, the directional air dodge. Great spacing from Armadillo. They're not going to get clipped by the forward smash.
Yep, having to be very careful right now as we go back to the Ivysaur here to try to clean up the mess.
Yeah, it's so scary to throw out any Razor Leaf. The Aura Sphere is just so strong, and Armadillo completely trapping Ned. Not a lot of options. Maybe could have switched, but is able to connect the up air, and the high ceiling paying off here. Low rage on the Charizard. The up smash isn't going to KO Armadillo off the top here.
Yeah, but Armadillo having a rough time trying to get back to center stage right now. Eventually able to find Respite on the side platform, and now able to break, you know, free a little bit into neutral here. So Ned at you know, still continue to add on his pressure right now.
Okay, tricky landing. Ned, no punish on that. It couldn't. Ooh, ducks underneath the Aura Sphere. Like the option here, jumping over, ducking under everything. See if he can get this KO. Tries to get the jump from Armadillo, but this is scary. Oh, wow, almost gets the edge guard and dies for it. Isn't going to get back the two frame. The down tilt from Charizard evening things up here for Ned.
Yeah, once again, the Noggin being the equalizer right there. So Ned able to get himself back in the last stock situation. So let's see if he's going to be able to, you know, mount this comeback. You know, 83% is definitely nothing to scoff at. And, you know, Squirtle is not known for his durability. So smart switch to the Ivysaur right here.
One thing that can be tough for Lucario in this scenario, like, Lucario's still in a comfortable spot, but if Lucario's at just 0%, he's not going to have a lot of options that, like, are just straight kill moves that can kill, you know, Ned at this percent outside of, like, smash attacks. So, going to have to work a little bit harder to get that KO percent, and it looks like this is going to be enough. No, the switch to Zard is enough, but the snipe after the switch! Oh my goodness, Armadillo with the call out.
Yeah, Aura Sphere playing true to its in-game characteristics. I believe that move does not miss when you use it in the native Pokemon games. But yeah, great awareness right there from Armadillo. Again, Ned's DI was pristine, you know, on that Ivysaur stock, but great awareness to just throw out the Aura Sphere. Ned's that deep into the blast zone. All you have to do is look at him too long, and he was gonna die. And we're already starting off the block, you know, the way that you know. Sakurai intended us to Charles with a game five.
Yeah, no, nothing short here, especially for Armadillo. This is his fourth game five set in a row. Man is running a marathon. So we'll see what happens here next. Armadillo, like, just great awareness after the back air, knowing that because Armadillo didn't have, you know, too much aura, still having the awareness to set up the offstage edge guard, and, you know, aura or not, if you're that close to the blast zone with that Aura Sphere, you're gonna get KO'd. So really, really good stuff there.
All right, so small battlefield will be the final stage here. We saw Ned make excellent use of the stage in the game that he won earlier in the set. So, you know, let's see if he can make Lightning Strike twice here, or if Armadillo will mount once again another game five comeback, like we mentioned.
Yeah, okay, starting things off slow here, definitely. Don't blame Ned for that. Obviously, you want to take it a little slow here. Don't want to... I mean, it was such a... The last two games were just so, so close, right? And it just... It's crazy because it really comes down to that backer. How many times have we seen Armadillo go... You know, that was the go-to move. The Aura Sphere, the back airs, multiple threats here. Almost gets the tech in place there with the down smash. One thing to note is Squirtle's down smash is extremely low on cooldown. So once you do the move, you know, you have very little, and like, it's a very difficult move to whip punish.
All right, so right now it is Ned out in out the gate strong in his early stock here, about breaking out to a 70% lead. And again, Ivysaur on the ledge, one of the scariest characters in the game. That character having you know, a plethora of options to edge guard you with, but doesn't matter when Charizard has, once again, the Noggin to kill you off the top. So Ned striking first here in game five, Charles.
Yeah, yeah. So Ned, honestly, not taking that much damage, but how many times have we seen Armadillo in this situation and is able to bring it back with that aura, especially on that last stock? I feel like Armadillo definitely powers up and plays extremely well on that last stock, and that's realistically the most impactful stock for sure, especially when it comes to Lucario, just because of how the aura mechanic works. But Ned, honestly, making this lead so large that I don't even know if Armadillo is going to have the chance.
Yeah, no, he's looking awfully solid right now in this game five. You know, whatever it is, something has awoken from him. Oh, in the last up air, almost killing him though, my goodness.
Almost killing Zard. This aura is absolutely insane. The aura does not only get powered up with the percentage deficit, but also with the stock deficit as well. And as you can see, that was such a nice Aura Sphere in to cancel right into the Force Palm there. So much knockback on that command grab, and he was just clearly done. But the forward smash, wow, no rage required. Ned just firing right back, taking that second stock.
Yeah, and it's broken out into a two-stock lead here. Has not been touched on the second stock yet, Charles. And everything just coming up Milhouse, you know, for Ned right now. He is putting on a clinic.
Okay, let's roll here. He's going to be able to dash back to the center stage. I like that Ned didn't do any buffer attack, just got the roll, claimed center stage again, and he's going to play this, you know, to the T, just sit on this lead, space out Lucario. Try not to get too close, or if you do interact, make sure you have those buttons on deck. Lucario doesn't have the quickest buttons, so, you know, that's definitely the general strategy Ned is going for here. It's really scary, but, like, you don't want to give Lucario too much space because that's when the Aura Sphere starts, you know, taking place. You want to play that nice mid-range.
Yeah, got to be extra careful here. Ooh, nice little conversion right there. And as you can see, the Aura Sphere is nearing that danger percent right now, but it's going to take a lot more than just that. Oh, that's a good way to get it started, though, as Armadillo lands the F smash and brings her back down to one stock here.
Yeah, missing the tech versus Armadillo. I guess the cost for that is an entire stock there. The forward smash is able to cover that missed tech, and that is, you know, one way to really bring things back here. And this aura is definitely pumped up and ready to go. Here comes the damage, but Charizard falling right out of the combo there. Ooh, the Orsher into the grab. I like the idea.
Yeah, you see Ned trying to sniff out these jumps. That's why he's going for these up airs and neutral airs. Ooh, so close.
So scary. Like, even though it's Zard at 59, you know, if you, especially if you played Smash, like, you know how powerful this aura is. So this is there's the parry into the I think you wired up Smash.
Oh,
wait
no!
a minute! No, not like that. Oh my goodness, Armadillo gets the punish. Ned tries to go for the up smash, gets the up tilt, then goes for the forward smash after. Armadillo just has the shield discipline, holds the shield, gets the correct punish afterwards, and that is how Armadillo is going to qualify into the next phase of Smash World Tour. Wow, what a set. Game 5 situation, last stock, last hit, man.
You know what they say, Charles, it's not over till the last Pokemon sings. And my God, listen, kudos to Armadillo. Like we mentioned before, he had to play 4 straight sets worth of Game 5 Smash. And, you know, I don't care what competitive setting you're competing in, to have that sort of, you know, mental fortitude and, like, stamina